Hi, everybody. My name is Harry Kestler. I'm the professor of microbiology here at the college. I'm also known as the microprof. And I'm also, for the last 35 years, a molecular virologist. And it seems that a lot of people are interested in viruses these days. I read a journal called Morbidity and Mortality Weekly Report. Morbidity and Mortality Weekly Report stands for morbidity, for those of you who don't know, is disease. Mortality is death. Those are two real popular subjects, I guess, disease and death. And I've added a third column here, and that third column is misery. And I'm here to tell you that we have some misery to go through in the next few days, but we will come out on the other side. I'm confident we will come out on the other side on top of this. Now, I have been doing calculations about what, for the last month, about what's going on in China versus everywhere else. And I've come up with this. I've looked at cases. Cases are sometimes underreported, so I went with deaths. So these are the number of people who have died with COVID-19 virus, which is the coronavirus that is currently around. And there's about 4,000 total as of today. That number will go up as time goes on. And so what you can see here is these are the number of cases in China. And I want you to really pay attention to what's going on right there. This is real. And I'm going to plot more data as time goes on. China is recovering. China has beat this. China, in fact, President Xi stepped foot in Wuhan City yesterday on Tuesday. And he signaled that Wuhan City, which is the epicenter of this whole story, is under control. Now that takes us to us. We're Americans and we want to know what's going on with us. And that shows you where we are. And I have to tell you where we are is, as time goes on, we are about here. Let's go to, let's say, the 5th. The 5th of March. And if you draw back to this line here, that corresponds to the 5th of February for the Chinese. We've got one more month. We've got one more month of misery to get through, one more month from the 5th to get to the point where we are where China is. Now, some of you may be wondering about why we're doing what we're doing. The net result is going to be why the governor chose to do and all the schools and all the colleges have chosen to do what we are doing is the following. If we do not do closures and some of these social distancing protocols, we get a peak earlier. And the problem with getting a peak earlier, you might say, well, why don't we just suffer through it? And, you know, 2 weeks from now, we all either get sick or die, or we either get better or we don't. And the reason is because this is going to be a massive strain on our healthcare capacity. We have only so many. We have only so many infectious disease beds in Northeast Ohio. And so what we're trying to do is actually flatten the peak out, delay the peak, delay when the virus actually hits. It will. This is an inevitable thing. And so we may be longer than this may be longer than a month, but we will all come out better on the other side. And for those that are vulnerable, who need healthcare, who need the emergency services, they're going to be able to get those cases a little bit better because we will be at healthcare capacity, not above it. At this scenario, we have more morbidity, more mortality. So the idea is to blunt it so that we get less morbidity, less mortality. And so I encourage you all to wash your hands, not touch your face. I have begun a protocol with my students that if they see me touch my face, they point it out, and then I have to go and wash my hands. And so we should do that for each other. Social distancing is a distance of 6 feet. So if two people hold their hands out, that is about how far you should be. We are all trying to make protocols that will keep our students safe, and yet we will be able to do our job and get through this, and hopefully we all get through it together. I have a lot of faith in the people and the students here at the community college. I think we will rise to the occasion, and I wish you all good health, and thanks for listening.